sostanzialmente quello che è il comportamento della matrice pseudo-inversa, cioè se io vado a calcolare, allora A è una matrice Cm per n, B è un vettore, quindi A più è una matrice Cm per n, B è un vettore in Cm. Allora, chi è A più B? E si dice la soluzione ai minimi quadrati let us take the matrix A, in this case Rm times n. You know that this space, or what is this? It is the X in Rn such that A of X. Here in this context, because the span of columns of C of A, usually it's called F of A because of the rank in N. And why is this easy to prove? You can prove it by linear functions associated to matrix A, but you can prove even in another. You can say A of X equal to 0 instead to write it, this system can be written in four different ways. It can be written extensively A11 X1 plus down is basically the rows. And if I write down the rows, this is A1, the first row of A, start. A, it is F of A orthogonal. So in this context, R of A does not mean the rank of A. It means the span of the rows of A. So C of A, it means the span of the columns of A. So remember that this is in Rn, and this is in Rn. This is in Rn, and this is in Rn. Okay? But the sum of these two dimensions equals to n, the dimension of the domain. This goes, this matrix can be seen as a linear application from Rn to Rn. Okay? So, the dimension of R of A and the dimension of C of A, they are equal. Why? They are in different spaces, but they are equal because you know that the rank, this is the rank of the matrix. So, since it is the rank of the matrix, it is equal. Now, you know, the rank of the matrix is K, so this dimension of both equal to and so, what do you know when you take the orthogonal space? This is the dimension of the Hult space, that in this case is Rn, is n. Let us say that this dimension was, okay, it's not necessary. Rn minus Rn. When you take the orthogonal, if the orthogonal has the previous space at some dimension k, this dimension is n minus 2. So you see that the sum of these dimensions is equal. Okay? Oh, so this is first point to be clear. So, what does it change when we take matrix with convex coefficients? Of course, this is Cn, this is Cn. Then this is the same writing, but this changes. Why? Because this is not anymore X Hermitian. So this is we cannot use color code like here. And so we have XAM conjugate. Why conjugate? Because the relation is the same as before. But if I put A1 here, I will get XA11 plus A11 conjugate. Because permittable, you have to take the conjugation. Before I wrote in the other direction because it was the same. But now, let's put X on the left and 12, that the rows on the right, but then I have to put not the rows, but the conjugate of the rows. Otherwise, I will not get this. I will get all the fishes conjugated. So, what does change here? We have this. The nucleus of A now is orthogonal to M of A conjugate. The span of the rows, not of A, but of the conjugated matrix of A. Okay? And this is. Well, this doesn't change anything about the dimensions. You know, if some linear combination is zero, you take conjugation for the load of A conjugate, you get the conjugation that with the conjugated coefficients, the sum. Actually, you remember AX equals B, then you have AX equal to BC, okay? But then system is solvable, it's compatible, because this was projected on a space of columns of A, so now the solvability condition is satisfied in the shapeability. But then, how is any solution? How can be written? If I take one x0, ax0 equals to bc, you have that x will be x0 plus b. No? And when you will is in the nucleus of A. That x0 is the least, the solution with the least, the smallest length. Okay? Then x0 is satisfies this, but I can, at least should be correct for each v in this orthogonal space. This happens if and only if x0 is in F of A. Why? This is the space of solutions, a fine space. You have here you have the origin, here you have x0. If this is N of A, you see that X0, in order to be the shortest solution, has to be orthogonal to N of A. Otherwise, if it is not, you project, subtract projection, and when you subtract the projection, the norm decreases. And since the projection is in the nucleus, in the cavern, since the projection is in the cavern, then it's still solution, and it will be another solution. Otherwise, you can just take the square here, write down. It is clear. This is clear. So, what does it mean? That x0 to be the shortest has to be orthogonal to this. But this was the orthogonal to this. So, when you take the orthogonal twice, you come back to the original space. This infinite space is true. So, in order to prove that A plus B it is the least square solutions, we have to prove that X0 is A plus B. So, X0, we have to prove that is the solution of this problem. Okay? First. And second, we have to prove it suffices to prove that A plus B is in this space. Okay? Because if it is in this space, then it's the shortest. Okay? But now we start to prove the first. Thank you. start from this
system.
Solvable, not solvable, it's not important. Then we add this associated system. This is projection. Of B over on CA, and this is the mesh solution.
I want to prove lemma.
AS is equal to BC if and only if AH AX is equal to AH. So this first point. And this point is interesting, it's by itself.
So
we start from a system not comparable. I just say that if I multiply on the left for the Hermitian matrix of A, then the system is comparable, is solved. And solutions are exactly the same solutions of this. Vector, this should be true for every y invite Joshua that AX 950 AZ is equal to 0 for any Z, whatever Z in Cn. Because if Z is Cn, A of Z is.
Sure, if
priori we don't know if there is infinite knowledge. What we have to do, it is sufficient to prove that dimension of the affine spaces of solution is the same. And this Luce capito. The system of solutions here, this is solvable. This is solvable because any solution of this will solve this. So also this is solvable. And if the two systems, these systems are in Rn, x is in Rn in both cases. Okay? But the dimension of the solution, the solution space, it depends only on the rank of the matrix. And you remember that if the rank of matrix A is equal to the rank of the matrix this we proved last time. So since that these two matrices have the same rank, the solution space is has the same dimension. And then if this they are both affine space, this affine space contains this, because every solution of this is the solution of that. And they are both the same dimension, so they should be. So let us repeat error. First point. You are the span of the rows, the span of the columns, and the span of the rows of the conjugate. You know the span of the rows is the image of A, the rank. Rank is both for the dimension of the minor as the biggest, the highest dimension of any minor with non-zero determinant, but it is also called the image of A when A it is seen as a linear application. Why? Because they coincide. The rank of A as image has the same dimension as the rank of A as number. The dimension of the rank of A is the rank of A, but in one meaning you have to. La dimensione dell'immagine è il rank. In italiano ce la capiamo perché tu chiami rango l'immagine e rank RG, in genere scrivo in italiano scrivo RG per dire la dimensione dell'immagine. RK per dire il rango poi sono qua. Ok? Ok. Poi abbiamo visto che then we saw that kernel of A is the can be seen as the orthogonal to what? In when A is real matrix to the orthogonal of the span of the rows. The span of the rows, the span of the columns, obviously they have the same dimension. When I take the orthogonal, I take the dimension of the space in which both are contained, the ambient space, that is n minus the dimension of the other. But in actually, when we have a complex valued matrix, the kernel of A is orthogonal to the rank of A bar, the conjugate. But dimensions that don't change. Then just prove this lemma. First of all, we want to move from the system, the original system, that maybe was not solvable, to the solvable system obtained when I project B on the image of A. So over on C of A, that is the image. Actually, we don't do this actually when we have to solve we have to compute the minimum, the least square solutions of this system. We do another way. We don't do this. We just multiply on the left by AH, and we obtain a new system. This system is solved, and it is not this. This is not BC, because this is not A. But this system, it has the same solutions of this. So, first lemma, it says it's not important to compute BC. You can do it, but it can be done, because you can compute the basis of C of A and take projection as the usual formulas for projection. But if you do the justice, you obtain an equivalent system. Equivalent test exactly the same solutions. In one way we prove, then since the rank of these two matrices is the same, then they both have the same affine space of solutions and the same solutions. Okay? Okay. Maybe you take a small breath. So, we proved the answer. Now we just have to prove what we have to do. Here, we want to prove that A plus B, this belongs to F of A bar. We have to prove this. And we have to prove that A plus B this is equal to and this means, by what we told before, it means that A plus B is a solution of this system, so it is a solution of this system, but it is the shortest one. Why? Because it is in L of A bar. Okay? Proof. plus B a Z is equal to zero, we have to do, we have to prove. Whatever Z belonging to A, to the kernel of A. If we have to prove this, okay, so but if let us take A plus B this is all this way this is true for every W for every no for every in the kernel of A. This is true. We know that this is true. Why? Because A plus B A Z this is equal to zero. And if we take this on the other side this we know. So if we multiply let us okay let us prove first let us prove the second let us prove that A plus is equal to A. Okay, I want to do first this. Why? because if A is A A plus, if I multiply by A this is A H A. Okay? Okay. This, why? Because I know that this is A. Plus A plus. Because you remember. determined that A plus is thus A, B plus. But this you can write two times. Just a preview of what we will do tomorrow. First of all, we apply this result. So So the least square solutions, for example, you all know that you have some data and you want to interpolate this data with, for example, with a straight line. This is a very particular case also with the least square solutions system. Okay? You want to find the problem that in this case x is not in R2. Okay, you have Bn, m is very big, and you want to find just two parameters for the slope of slope and the variance of some straight line. But this can be seen very, and so we can derive again some results you should all know about the approximation. It is called the least square. Yes. And it's very, very simple case. Oh. Then we have to finish the to speak about the QR decomposition, if you remember. Mm-hmm. And to connect the QR decomposition with this. So if you have some QR decomposition of A, how this result specializes. And then third we have to move on and to do other singular variable decomposition and some other stuff. Okay? But we have not to do we have three lessons left. Should be sufficient. Okay.